Praise the Lord. We often ask this question, what is sin? And what is the consequence of sin? Though we know very well, Romans 6:23 says, the wages of sin is death. In today's first reading from the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 24, we find God has called each one of us for a purpose. And as we read in the book of Ephesians 3:20, God is at work in us to fulfill his purpose in our lives. As we read in the book of Philippians 2:13, God has his own way to fulfill his will in our lives. God has a plan for us. God is at work in us. And it is he who works in us, fulfills God's plan in our lives. So we need to move with God, walk with God. If we read the book of Genesis chapter 5, we read, Enoch walked with God. Enoch didn't have a problem. He had a lot of problems. But he learned to walk with God. Means moving with God. Moving with God's thinking. Putting oneself into the hands of God. We read in the book of Genesis chapter 6, Noah walked with God. We read in Genesis chapter 12, Abraham walked with God. These are the people who walked with God, means not that they didn't have thinking, not that they didn't have intelligence, but they kept all of them. And as we read in the book of Job chapter 42, he questioned, many questions to the Lord, and then he says, Lord, I put my hand on my mouth and I speak no more, for you know what is best. And here I am. So walking with God is very, very important. God chose David for a purpose. We know very well how God was at work in the life of David. When King Saul was telling him, you are a small boy. You don't have experience in the battle. And Goliath is a very big man. So the king who is supposed to encourage him to go for the battle is discouraging him. Because people see the battles, but those who have the victory see God. Many people lose their lives because they see the battle. And the battle looks very big for them. Very few, whatever may be the battle, they see their God. So David knew the Lord very well. He said, when I was in the field, when the lions came, tigers came, God gave me the power. I pulled the mouth of the lions and rescued the sheep. And the same God will rescue me, rescue his people. So he is not focusing on Goliath. He is focusing on God. Now another temptation comes. Goliath himself stands and says, hey, come, do you think I am a dog? He wants David to focus on him. That is the technique of Satan. Satan will make us to focus on ourselves and on the battle. He will make us to focus on ourselves and on our enemy. And on the problem we face. That's what Goliath said. Come on, man. Do you think I am a dog? You come with a stick, I will kill you. Dash, dash, and so on. But David said, stupid fellow, I come in the name of the Lord who made heaven and the earth. The Lord will give the victory. The Lord will fight against you. And the Lord will give you into my hands. So, when we go through the battles, the secret to come out of it is to focus on the Lord. Focus on the Lord. So David knew very well that he is chosen by God for a purpose to defeat Philistines and protect Israelites. He knew God is at work in him. He also knew that God's purpose will be fulfilled through him. But still, when he became the king, he started to take care of the whole kingdom by himself. Very important decisions, he never consulted God. So you find even a small, this kind of things brings a lot of battles, a lot of crying, and because people will feel that they are left out. People get insecure and so on. Same thing happened in those days. God blessed David to be a father for everybody, to build up a nation. He is from Judah. And the Israelites came and they became one with him. And he is supposed to rule the whole together for 40 years. These are God's plan. God had a dream about David. But David started to count people. Who all are my people? Who all are the soldiers? Who all are this? Who all are that? Who all are this? It's all satanic elements to divide people, to destroy people. And David falls into that trick. Who all are his supporters? Who all will stand with him? God's heart was broken. He said, stupid fellow, I chose you to be a father for everybody, to be united and move with God. If God wants to develop your territory, you have to move in developing. Maybe God wants you to gather other people also with you. You have to move, win over them, love them, and rule them, and bring me, my presence to them. And when Satan attacks us, God never leaves us. Suddenly God puts some break or brings somebody in our lives. Suddenly to remind us, hey, you are going the wrong way. God will never leave his servants. The man who is in the battle, he comes and tells David, so beautifully it is written, the Lord's anger against Israel flared up, and he incited David against all the Israelites and so on. Accordingly, the king said to Job and the leaders of the army who were with him, tour all the tribes of Israel from Dan to Beersheba and register the people that I may know their number. But Job said to the king, may the Lord your God increase the number of people 100-fold for your royal majesty to see it with his own eyes. But why does it please my Lord, the king, to order a thing of this kind? Why do you restrict yourself only with this territory? Allow God to increase your territory. Be busy in building up the kingdom God has given to you. Be busy in loving the people, doing the welfare for the people. But David did not listen. And so it goes against the plan of God. Why God chose him. So the Lord says, the evil you have taken. When we yearn evil, when we sin, the consequence of sin doesn't remain only with us. It affects our family, it affects our territory, it affects all our friends, it affects everything. When I sin, it affects my family, it affects my friends, it affects my every work I do. That's why the Lord said, do you want a 3 years of famine because you sinned? In the famine, so many people will die. So your register will be nothing. Today you can do register. Tomorrow when God brings a famine, your register will be, your number will be wrong. A minute is enough for God, man, to destroy all that you have built if you don't build according to God. That's what God wants to tell him. Or he says, or to flee from your enemy 3 months while he pursues you. Means he will allow the enemy to overcome you. And he will be pursuing you, running behind you. For 3 months, 90 days, you would be frightened of your enemy. Your enemy will be winning over. If 90 days the enemy is in the territory of David, means what they will do? They will plunder everything. They will smash up everything. They will destroy everything. What are you building, man? God is saying. God is going to bring 3 months. Your enemies are going to run behind you. What are you going to do? I called you to build up God's kingdom. And you are building your own kingdom. God wants you to gather the people. But you try to make your own group and scatter, divide. When others come to know how they will feel, will they be able to love you? Will they be able to gather you? Will they be able to see you as one family? The more small group you go like that, the hatred, speaking ill of others and trying to harm others become part of that poisonous things.